Yang saya hormati Bapak Dr. Zakir Naik dengan rombongannya, para hadirin sekalian yang ada di tempat ini. Nama saya adalah Lamsen Naibaho. Tinggal di Bekasi, beragama Kristen Advent. Tidak makan babi, tidak minum bir, tidak minum kopi, tidak minum teh, tidak makan anjing, tidak makan belut, tidak makan kuda, dan banyak lagi tidak kami makan karena dilarang oleh Allah melalui Alkitabnya. Kalau melihat dari besarnya acara ini, saat ini rasanya ingin bersyahadat.
Cukup sebentar.
Kami
sebentar. Saya terjemahkan dulu.
Oke.
Okay. My name is Lamsen Naiban. I live in Bekasi, Christian Advent. I do not eat pork. I don't take alcohol, coffee, tea, and many other.
Why?
Because my God prohibit that in the book, in the Bible, in the Gospel. Because it is prohibited in the Gospel. I don't eat pork, I don't drink, take alcohol, coffee, tea, dog, and etc. Yes? And looking into this very big program tonight, actually, I would like to declare my shahada.
Masha, brother said that he's a Christian. He doesn't have alcohol, he doesn't have pork, he doesn't have coffee. And in this gathering, he wants to declare shahada. Brother, I would like to ask you, that do you believe that there is one God?
Saya yakin dan percaya bahwa Tuhan itu satu, Esa.
I believe that God is one.
Do you believe that Jesus Christ is the one, is the Almighty God, or is He a messenger of God? Jesus Christ is the one, is He God, or is He a messenger of God?
Nanti akan terjawab di dalam pertanyaan saya.
I will answer in my question.
I'm asking you, that you want to be declared Shahada. So I'm asking you, do you believe Jesus Christ is the one to be God, or to be a messenger of God?
Sampai saat ini, saya percaya bahwa Yesus adalah Tuhan.
I believe that Jesus is God.
Tuhan dan manusia.
God and man.
Can you point out a single unequivocal statement from anywhere in the Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says, any unambiguous statement where he says that I am God, or where he says worship me? Where does Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, say anywhere in the Bible that he is God, or where he says worship me?
Nanti akan terjawab dalam pertanyaan saya.
I will answer in my question later.
There are only one question you can ask. For later question you have to go behind the queue.
Ya, tanya satu pertanyaan.
We only finish your question. Your question is over. You have any question to ask? If your question is over, then only I start speaking. Unless your question is not over, I don't start speaking. I thought your question was over. If you have any question, ask the question first.
Okay, terima kasih. Tadi saya mengatakan sepertinya saya mau bersyahadat melihat besarnya acara ini.
Tapi ada tiga pertanyaan yang ada di dalam hati saya yang tidak bisa saya jawab. Dan inilah menjadi penghalang saya untuk bersyahadat. Tapi saya yakin dan percaya bahwa Bapak Dr. Zakirnain, bila bisa menjawab pertanyaan saya, bila bisa menjawab pertanyaan saya melalui Al-Quran, saya bersyahadat.
Right, I have three questions which still hinder me from declaring my belief to be Muslim. This tricky question, if you can't answer based on Quran, I will declare my shahada. Yes, the question please. Langsung Pak, pertanyaannya langsung.
Pertanyaan saya mohon berikan waktu kepada saya. Pertanyaan ini antri, tapi sabar. Demi kebenaran, demi kebaikan. Saya bertanya dahulu. Jika di dalam pertanyaan saya nanti saya menggunakan ayat-ayat suci Al-Quran, ingin bertanya kepada seluruh hadirin, apakah saya dinyatakan menista agama atau menghina Al-Quran? Karena di dalam pertanyaan saya banyak menggunakan ayat-ayat suci Al-Quran. Tidak menista? Al-Quran berkata
dalam Surah 9 ayat 22. Your question should be short. Two or three sentences. You are giving such a long speech that you are speaking. I am a Dalai. I am a Dominican missionary. I am a Dominican pastor. I am a Dominican father. Please, brother, ask the question brief, two or three sentences, not more, though you are speaking Bahasa. If you speak for more than two or three sentences, it will not be entertaining. You have already spoken more than 15-20 sentences, brother. Do you understand? Yes or no? Do you understand me?
Okay.
Your question should be two or three sentences. Brother, what's your name? What is your name?
Lamson Naibah.
And what's your profession?
Saya pensiunan PNS dan menjadi pembawa berita baik.
Retired government official.
Hold your question in two or three sentences. There are many people waiting in the queue. You cannot do injustice. Short question. Don't give background. Okay, go ahead.
Okay. Cuma saya takut kurang dipahami, jadi pertanyaan saya ini sangat. Oke, saya siap menanya dengan singkat. Pertanyaan saya.
Okay, wait. What did you say?
Apakah Isa itu asli?
Wait, brother. Two or three sentences, please.
Okay.
Do you understand two or three? What do you say two or three in Bahasa? Dua tiga.
Pertanyaan saya hanya satu barangkali, tidak bisa tiga?
What is this question?
Bisa satu.
If you do not ask your question in the next two sentences, we will ask the next person to come on the microphone. You are wasting the time of more than 50,000 people, brother. I am very kind, but you cannot waste the time. You are wasting the time.
Okay, you can hand over to all the people, please.
Ask your question directly. Only ask one question, which is the most important.
Apakah Isa itu Yesus?
Isa, the prophet, is Jesus?
I think you will do your lecture. I said in my lecture that we know Muslim is a Muslim unless he believes in Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. Every Muslim, if he has to be a Muslim, he has to believe in Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. We believe that he was one of the mightiest messengers of God. Brother, did you hear my lecture?
Saya di negara Indonesia.
Did you hear my lecture, yes or no? Don't give speeches. Did you hear my lecture, yes or no?
Kurang paham.
Actually,
just
understand you.
So if you do not hear my lecture, if you would like to ask me a question, I said in my lecture, it is compulsory every Muslim should believe in Jesus Christ. Why did you take a translation headphone? There are hundreds and thousands of headphones here. Why did you not take a headphone? Brother, ask him why did he take a headphone?
Whose fault is it, my fault or your fault?
Why did you take this headphone?
Tidak dipersiapkan oleh panitia, jadi saya.
This question is Jesus the same with Isa? The same person?
Yes, Jesus and Isa are the same. In Arabic we say Isa. In other languages, they twist it and they make it Jesus. He is the one and the same person.
Okay, masih bisa bertanya selanjutnya.
Can you ask second question?
Okay, short and sweet.
Cepat.
Kalau Isa itu Yesus, apakah pernah ada terjadi peristiwa pembunuhan Yesus atau penyaliban Isa?
If Isa is Jesus, was there actually crucifixion of Jesus or Isa?
Crucifixion.
Yes. If Isa is Jesus, was there true that he was crucified?
Okay, now I would want the translator to translate while I'm giving the answer. Are you listening? Okay, now listen carefully to my answer. The question Jesus asked, that was Isa alayhi salam or Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, crucified? You want to know who was crucified? Jesus or Isa? Is that your question?
Yes, I'm not.
Is it Jesus or Isa? That's what you want to know.
Tadi saya pertanyaan pertama, apakah Isa Yesus? Kalau Isa itu Yesus, apakah pernah Yesus atau Isa pernah disalib, dibunuh, mati dan bangkit kembali?
My first question is that Isa is the same with Jesus. It is the same. Was he crucified?
Okay. The reply is given in the Quran, in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 157. Wa ma qataluhu. It starts with the Qawlihim, Inna al-qatala al-Masihu, Isa ibn Maryam Rasulullah. They said in both the Jews that we in Jesus, the son of Mary, Ma qataluhu wa ma salluhu. They killed him not, neither did they crucify him. Walakin shubbiha lahu. It was only meant to appear so. All those who differ are full of doubts. They are full of doubts, only conjecture to follow. For truly they killed him not. So according to the Quran, he was not killed, he was not crucified. The next verse, Surah Nisa chapter 5 verse 158, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has raised him up alive unto himself. As far as the Quran is concerned, Quran is very clear, very explicit. Surah Nisa chapter 4 verse number 157, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was not killed, he was not crucified. Now I give you the answer from my Bible.
Okay.
Do you believe in the Quran?
Kalau pertanyaan.
Do you believe in the Quran, yes or no?
Sampai saat ini belum.
No, I will give you the answer from your Bible. Do you believe in the Bible?
Percaya Injil.
Do you believe in the Bible?
Yes, percaya Injil. Yes.
Okay. I have given the talk
crucifixion or crucifixion. Of all Jesus Christ, please be upon him here crucified. Time will not permit me to give the full lecture and the debate. I'll give you only one side. If you read the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 12, verse number 38, it says, when people ask Jesus Christ, please be upon him,
O Lord, O Master, do you show miracles and signs? So Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, replied, ye men of iniquity, you evil people, you ask for a sign, no sign shall be given to you except the sign of Jonah. For as Jonah was 3 days and 3 nights in the belly of the fish, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and 3 nights in the heart of the earth. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, is putting all of their in one basket. He said, you evil and adulterous generation, seek the after the sun. No sun shall be given to you, but the sign of Jonah. Brother, do you know the sign of Jonah? Brother, do you know the sign of Jonah, yes or no? Yes or no?
Pertanyaannya kurang jelas, terlalu panjang, jadi singkat-singkat.
Do you know the sign of Jonah, yes or no? Do you know the sign of Jonah, yes or no? Do you know Prophet Jonah? Do you know Prophet Jonah?
Oh, Yunus tahu. No,
yes,
he tahu.
Every Christian has to know the sign of Jonah, because the teaching was even in Sunday school. The sign of Jonah, if you read the Bible, in the book of Jonah, it is hardly one and a half side. Almighty God asked Prophet Jonah in the Quran and in the Quran, to go and deliver the message to the people of Nineveh. He goes to Joppa, thinking that the people of Nineveh will not understand him, will not follow the message. While he's going in a boat, a storm comes. It was a superstition of that time, that a storm comes in the sea when someone disobeys the master. So the people wanted to try out lots who in the ship had disobeyed the master, so that we can throw him overboard. Jonah being a prophet of God, he volunteers, I am the prophet of God, I have disobeyed my master, throw me overboard. When did they throw Jonah in the sea? I want to ask you a question. Was Jonah dead or alive? According to the Bible.
Berdasarkan cerita atau sejarahnya dalam Alkitab. Dia hidup di dalam perut kita.
Brother, why are you giving sentences?
I'm asking if he's dead or alive. Where are you sitting? Why are you giving sentences?
Hidup di dalam
perut kita. Live.
Why don't you open your mouth?
Yes, live.
If you're not giving the microphone to him. Whenever you open your mouth, you decline, huh? Don't make your mouth stop.
Yes.
Live. He, now, Prophet Jonah is thrown in a storm. In a storm.
When a fish comes and gobbles him up, a man ought to die. Was Jonah dead or alive?
Hidup.
Very good. Alive. Miracle of miracle. 3 days and 3 nights, the fish, according to the Bible, takes him around. Heat suffocates in the belly of the fish. Any human being ought to die. According to the Bible, was Jonah dead or alive?
Saya yakin dan percaya Allah itu Maha Kuasa, Maha
I believe that you are alive. I believe that God is Almighty.
Okay. Alive.
Hidup.
Hidup. Alive.
Hidup. Yes.
Hidup.
Forget mati.
Mati.
Yes.
Mati or hidup.
Yes.
Mati or hidup. Hidup. Alive. The fish gobbles up. The fish vomits out Jonah on the beach. Jonah the Decalai. Hidup or mati?
Hidup.
Marshall. Alive, 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 alive. Miracle of a miracle of a miracle of a miracle. When a person is thrown over in a storm, you have to die. You are not alive. A fish comes and gobbled up, yet he's alive. 3 days and 3 nights of vacation, yet he's alive. He vomited on the shore, yet he's alive. Alive, 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 alive. Miracle of a miracle of a miracle of a miracle. Now Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, today in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 12, verse number 38. For as Jonah was 3 days and 3 nights in the belly of the fish, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and 3 nights in the heart of the earth. When Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was put upon the cross. For crucifixion, a person ought to die. Crucifixion, according to the exposition, means a person is put to death on the cross. After Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was taken on the cross, he was put in a sepulcher in the heart of the earth. According to the Bible, was Jesus Christ dead or alive?
Di dalam kubur dia mati.
He died.
That means he did not fulfill the prophecy. That means Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, lied. Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 12, verse number 38, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, no sign shall be given to you except the sign of Jonah. As Jonah was 3 days and 3 nights in the belly of the fish, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and 3 nights in the heart of the earth. If Jonah was alive, even Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, should be alive. If he died, that means he didn't fulfill the prophecy. Do you mean to say Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, lied? Was Jesus Christ alive? I love Jesus Christ. If you say that, I will get angry. How dare you say that Jesus Christ was a liar, peace be upon him? Brother, did Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, lie? Did he lie, yes or no? Yes or no?
Saya tidak bisa mengatakan dia bohong. Baik, maksud dan tujuan ayat
I cannot say something.
You cannot say. But if Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, is saying in your Bible that as Jonah was, if Jonah was alive, he has to be alive. It is so clear cut. Why do you think he is dead? Where does it say in the Bible he was dead? He never claimed that he was dead. You are thinking wrong. Should you believe in the Bible or not? Are you a Christian? Are you a Christian?
I am Christian.
Yes.
So why don't you believe in the Bible? Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 12, verse number 38. Don't you believe in the prophecy of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him? Do you believe or not?
Perumpamaan yang diberikan Yesus bukan seperti itu.
The example given by Jesus is not like that.
Berbeda.
The example given by Jesus is not like that. He said.
I'm quoting to you, Gospel of Luke. You make me understand what is the sign of Jonah. You make me understand. If you know the Bible better than me, make me understand. What is the sign of Jonah? Tell me. Tell me. Educate me.
Saya bukan mengatakan lebih paham.
I don't say that
pemahaman kita berbeda.
I don't think that I have an understanding better than you.
If you don't have understanding better than me, then follow me. So according to the Bible, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, fulfilled the sign of Jonah. He was put on the cross, but he did not die on the cross. Same thing as the Quran says, Vama kataluhu vama salabuhu. They killed him not, neither did they crucify him. It was only made to appear so. Appear so.
Okay,
so do you believe Jesus wasn't crucified? According to the Bible, forget the Quran. Do you believe Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was not crucified? Do you believe? If you don't believe, then we are talking to you.
Mati di kayu salib.
Yeah, he is dead in the cross.
Where did Jesus say that? I'm quoting the Bible. Jesus Christ prophesied, as Jonah was 3 days and 3 nights, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and 3 nights. Do you mean to say Jesus Christ lied, peace be upon him? Do you want to call Jesus Christ a liar, Nauzubillah?
Kesamaannya.
Brother, do you want to call Jesus Christ a liar?
Kesamaannya.
Jesus Christ, answer my question. Do you want to call Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, a liar?
Tidak bohong.
No.
Kare. So he is an Olympian, so why are you saving them? Are you following the teachings of Jesus Christ or something? Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 12, verse number 38, and give me the reference. Are you following the teachings of Jesus Christ or me that can? Who is a better Christian, you or me? Who is a better Christian, you or me?
Untuk masalah lebih baik dan lebih pintar dan lebih tahu.
It is not tapi pemahaman
zakir naik.
Dengan pemahaman saya,
sangat berbeda.
But my langit dan bumi
really different from yours.
If you are different, then we will not believe in Jesus Christ speaking upon it. My thing is Jesus Christ speaking upon it. Even according to the Bible, he did not die on the cross. He was not crucified. So who told you he was crucified? Who told you? Where did you get this from?
Mas tercatat di dalam Matius dan Markus Yesus itu mati dan mati, tapi itu karena pertanyaan tidak mati dan yang menjadi pertanyaan saya tidak mungkin saya bacakan malam ini. It is impossible for me to read it now.
So who's calling you? I've been asking this question for 25 years on the Peace TV channel. Get me one verse. I have debates with the Doctor of Divinity. I have debates with your bishop, with your pastor. Who is your most famous pastor in Indonesia?
Pastor, saya tidak percaya kepada pastor, hanya percaya kepada Alkitab.
I don't believe in the PS, I believe in Alkitab.
You believe in
Alkitab? Alkitab,
you don't know the Kitab, I don't know the Kitab. If you believe in the Kitab, I'm talking about the Bible. Why don't you believe in the Bible? This is your lying. If you don't know who's to blame, you are to blame, not me. So according to the Bible, and to the, according to the Quran, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was not crucified, he was not killed. What is your third question? What is your third question?
Pertanyaan ketiga, Papa.
Pertanyaan berapa? Ketiga?
Tiga.
Pertanyaan saya tadi. Kalau ada peristiwa penyalipan, siapakah yang tersalib itu?
If there was crucifixion, who was crucified?
I think the brother did not hear the translation of the Quran, they said. Quran is very clear cut. In Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 157, I'm repeating it. وَقَوْلِيَتْ إِنَّ الْقَتَنَّ الْمَثِيُّ إِتَبْنُ مَرِيمَ. They said in both the Jews, we killed Jesus the son of Mary. وَمَا قَتُلُهُ وَمَا صَلَبُهُ. They killed him not, neither did they crucify him. It was only made to appear so. All those who differ are full of doubts, إِلَّتِبَزَّمْ, with only conjectures to follow. For a yakina they killed him not. That means the Quran is very explicit. They did not kill him, neither did they crucify him. It was made to appear so. Who was crucified? I am not bothered in knowing. When Quran says, I should not be bothered, why should I be bothered? Whoever was crucified, I don't know. Why should I be bothered? I'm bothered about Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. When the Quran says Jesus was in crucified, peace be upon him. When the Bible says he was not. If somebody else was, why should I be bothered? I should only be bothered whether Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he himself was crucified or not. From the Quran I come to know he was not. From the Bible I come to know he was not. So why should I, when you are not doing research on Jesus, peace be upon him, why should I do research on somebody else? Hope that answers the question. I'm not bothered who was crucified. As long as Jesus, peace be upon him, wasn't crucified, the Quran is very clear. all those who defer the fall of doubt, I don't want to waste my time in doing research, who was crucified, was he or was he not? I am very clear, Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, wasn't crucified. Hope that answers the question. Then we have the next question.